South Africa's most bubbly TV personality and celebrity chef Ulona Maseko is well known as our very own culinary princess. She has been cooking up a storm and has also broken into international cuisine with her vast knowledge and expertise with food. Ulona, a warm and hearty welcome to the show this morning.
Hi, how are you?
I'm very well, thank you. How are you doing?
Good. You know, some good days, some bad days, you know. Just taking it one day at a time. Every hour counts, you know.
I definitely understand it because, I mean, let's face it, the nationwide lockdown means a lot of us get to spend a large amount of time at home. But what advice can you give viewers who are already bored with the same old predictable recipes that they've grown tired of?
You know what? I think it's about exploring. It's about being willing to fail at certain things and trying them again. If you're eating bap and stew every day, but maybe, you know, fry the stew as opposed to having it as an actual, like, masopo type of stuff, you know? Mm. So, you know, I just think it's about being innovative and trying to keep as healthy as possible as well. Because, I mean, it's easy to kind of get into old habits of what you like to eat, particularly from the 1st of May. 1st of May was like, it's that day, you know? But yeah, it's just about, you know, trying to just be innovative and being willing to take risks in the kitchen. If you were using chickpeas, for example, as part of a salad, why don't you put them in the grill and make them chickpeas snacks? You know, they become nice and crispy, put a few spices on them, and the family can snack on that as opposed to snacking on a packet of chips. You know what I mean? So
you
innovate.
Make it sound so easy peasy, like voila, there you go. I mean, you recently did a live cook along with Australian celebrity chef Sarah Todd, as well as Ghanaian food queen Kinora Awini. What was the idea behind this, and why did you choose to collaborate with these chefs?
We became friends online, and we just thought, why don't we connect online and do something special and do like a cook along? And the cook-alongs have had such a good reception, which is absolutely amazing. And I think particularly given this time, it's nice to connect with, you know, I was supposed to go to Ghana, I was supposed to go to London, I was supposed to travel. And, you know, now that that's not necessarily happening, I'm able to then, you know, connect with them online and let my supporters see and kind of gauge in on what she does. She's got the most amazing son, Sarah. And yeah, so that's kind of like how it came along.
I mean, the COVID-19 pandemic has, you know, halted so many plans for many people, whether short-term plans or long-term plans. But I know that you are celebrating currently. Your cookbook, Celebrate with Ulona Maseko, recently won 2 international awards. Congratulations! That's exactly what I'm talking about, Ulona. Please tell us more about the book and, of course, the awards and what it means to you.
It is absolutely amazing. So I won 2 cookbook awards, one Best International Cookbook and then one Best Celebrity Chef Cookbook, so which is absolutely amazing. I mean, I won alongside Nadia Hussein, who I interviewed on Top Billing.
Oh,
like
wow.
Last year, so to be, you know, to have interviewed her, they go, oh my god, like what an icon, and then to win next to her is like absolutely phenomenal.
Full circle.
And yeah, and so it's a huge milestone. You know, you work so hard in wanting to deliver an amazing product, and when you put your heart into something, like I said, it's a love letter from me to people that buy the book, and thank you to everyone that's bought the book. It's a phenomenal feat, so yeah.
You put your heart into everything that you do. I mean, I see it on your YouTube channel, Ulona Maseko, when you cook and the people that you engage with. I'm just like, I have so much FOMO, okay? But according to you, Ulona, with your experience over the years and your expertise, what does the restaurant and culinary industry look like in the future, especially for South Africa?
Jeez, I think it's going to be so different. I think, you know, different. I think a lot more cautious. You know, I think life is just going to be different besides this restaurant. But I think definitely, I mean, the whole thing about a restaurant, right, or food is that it brings people together. And this one particular thing has allowed us not to be together. So it's going to require a lot of clever thinking in terms of, you know, how many people you put in a restaurant. Then you've got to ask yourself questions like, will you make money? If you were, like, for example, a takeaway spot that had 60 seats, now you've got to have 30 seats. Does that economically make money? does it make sense for you to actually have a sit-in, you know? Or do we go online and everything is literally online? Because that's also possible. Maybe yes. The coming of people together isn't as possible now, but the online stuff is definitely possible because it's more controlled, right? You're able to say, okay, Zwaiki, Veronica, and Samantha work for me. And, you know, you're able to control where they go, how they go, hopefully. But, you know, I think it's still a big question on everyone's mind on how it's going to be possible. And I think it's going to be very different. But, I'm one of the most optimistic people. So I'm always like, you know, just try even if it's a 1% of something positive, that's enough to go ahead with something. You know, that's me in a nutshell.
Oh, Lona Maseko, I mean, celebrity chef, author, television presenter, what do you not do? We've definitely enjoyed celebrating with you this morning. Thank you for joining us, man. Your passion and love for the culinary arts has definitely paid off with the entire world to bear witness. May you continue to move and inspire the people of our country. Enjoy the rest of your morning.
Thank you. Thank you so much.